next topic is clutch. So maybe this term you have already heard of since your childhood, but what technically is a clutch? Suppose you don't have a clutch. So anytime your engine starts, so let your engine start, it will give power output, and as soon as there is power in the engine, there is also power at the wheels. So you start the engine, you get a jerk. In order to prevent that or to deliver energy at a controlled manner, we make use of clutch. So what is that? Let us say this is an engine. This engine has to be connected with the wheel. So if nothing is there, all power equal to all power. We want that even though the engine is running at 1000 rpm, we want the wheel to be running at 20 rpm. Slowly as we release the clutch, then this increases 60 rpm, 120, 280, dot dot dot, 1000 rpm. Now they can be equal. Now how to make these changes smoothly? Gear is one of the options, but gear is jerky. It would give you stepped output. There we make use of a clutch. Now what is clutch? This is an element which works on friction principle. So we have two plates. Connected like this. This one receives power from a prime mover. So power comes here. These two are friction plates, and this is connected to the output. If this is running at full RPM, this will run at full RPM because they are rigidly connected. But because this is friction dependent, the more we press the other plate on this, the more power it will transmit. If it is completely pressed, all the power will be transmitted. In order to control how much this has to be pressed, we make use of springs. We also make use of levers. And these are connected through cables which we operate with either with our hand or with legs. When we press them, this is pulled away. So vehicle, even though engine is running, vehicle comes slow. So it's static now. If you want to engage it, simply release it. So this would go and press against the friction plate, and then all the output will be available. Now these are called friction plates. These are springs. This is engine and this is output shaft. This is how the clutch works. The advantage is smooth power output from 0% to 100% of engine power. Okay. Without this, the engine would be operating in steps, either 100% on or 0% on. Now in this, the friction plates, after some time they wear off. Simple method is to replace the clutch, your vehicle is as good as new. So during the service, we generally change the friction pads of these plates. If you recall the rope experiment, in the rope if you make multiple turns of it, the friction is more. Similarly, here if we want that less wear and tear should be there and the friction should be more, we make use of intermediate plates. If you want to replace the plates, you are free to do so, they are quite cheap. And if you have multiple plates, the friction are more and then you get a better output. Some of these plates, they are immersed in oil according to their design. Clutches can come in dry clutch or wet clutch. Similarly, clutch can be primary or secondary. That means they can either be in between engine and gearbox, or they can be between gearbox and the driving driven wheel. So you might have observed one more thing, that in some of the vehicles we can apply the clutch and then kick start it, but in some of the vehicles you have to bring it to neutral, then only it can start. So that is the difference between primary and secondary clutches. So classification of clutch can be done as dry clutch, wet clutch. First classification, primary clutch, secondary clutch. Second classification, single plate clutch. Multi-plate clutch. Albeit, there is one more classification. You might have seen that at the scooties or the Luna, they don't have gears. What they have, when you accelerate them little bit more, afterwards they pick up. But when you are idling, even though you know that engine is running, but without the gear also, your clutch is not engaged. Now they make use of something called a centrifugal clutch. Centrifugal clutches are generally cone type. So this can be the friction pad and this can be the mating part. So when this goes inside, friction is created. And these are like rotating around these axes. So more friction, they rotate more. Okay, so we call them cone clutch. Some of them are friction, centrifugal clutch. Centrifugal clutch, what happens? If the RPM is more, there is an internally expanding brake pad. It goes and hits on the surface of an external cylinder, on the internal surface of an external cylinder, and then it applies the frictional force and then it tries to rotate it. The other ones are these radial ones or flat plate clutch. So this is a classification of the clutch. There can be many more. Like nowadays different varieties of clutches are coming. So maybe some other company might be manufacturing something which we have not seen yet. So that is not included in purview of this discussion. So you saw that the single plate clutch was simply two plates rubbing against each other. If we have multiple plates, what do? We have a shaft. On this shaft, we have multiple friction plates. Maybe another shaft, it also has something which goes over it, and on it, the intermediate friction elements are there. When you compress them together, they all get sandwiched and more friction is generated. Multi-plate clutch. The other one is the cone clutch. So much like a cone generally looks like this. You cut it from here, it would look like this. Let a shaft be connected over here such that now it looks like a table lamp or a kulfi. Now this can be inserted. Into something. Which looks like this. Maybe the mating part is here. You insert it. If there is friction, it will rub against it. This is known as cone clutch. there is one more. I am drawing the side view of it. So this is a shaft. On the shaft, we have spring-loaded elements which look like this. They rotate inside a cylinder like this. When this rotates, because of the centrifugal action, this goes and rubs against these surfaces. Higher is the RPM, higher is the movement of these elements, and higher is the frictional force at these points, and because of that, the outer one also rotates. This one is known as a centrifugal clutch. These are many times used in washing machine, also in Luna, Scooty, etc. Multi-plate clutches used in bikes, cars, etc. Single plate clutches can be used in tractor because you want a simple design but a very big one. Multi-plate clutches can be little bit smaller, but single plate ones, they need to be very big because there is only a single plate, and if it is not very big, the torque transmission will not be appropriate. So this is the classification of the clutch according to the configuration.